there are robots designed to lend a helping hand.
My name is Kiri.
And bots designed to interact with people. College students from across the U.S. are putting their brain power to work programming these robotic maneuvers. It's called SURE, a 10-week summer undergraduate research experience.
You're involved in research, you have hands-on applications. What happens is you're like, oh, I understand what calculus is about. I'm actually using it to design a robot and make it move.
With support from the National Science Foundation, robotics engineer Ayanna Howard of Georgia Tech and her colleagues are grabbing the attention of students from colleges big and small. The goal? Encourage underrepresented students to apply for cutting-edge graduate work in science and engineering.
When you design a robot for an individual or a child with a disability, you're providing a resource to change the world.
At NASA, Howard worked on the Mars Technology Program. But now one of her missions is to motivate and recruit undergraduates, like Brooke Bosley, to enter the field of robotics.
So you can get colors, you can get shapes, and then you can go to counting.
I feel that mentoring is very important, especially for minorities and females. It's not a lot of people out there who are very supportive when it comes to going into technology in the science field.
She has shoulder joints, elbow joints, wrist joints.
Participants learn the benefits of collaboration.
We all have our independent projects, but we're independently working together. So I've been setting up a web environment to be able to control robots remotely.
It's a program really designed to help people who want to pursue robotics in graduate school to kind of get their feet wet, so to speak. There are parts of robotics that I would never get to encounter because my institution doesn't have any robots.
Once we get it accurate enough that the robot can understand it, we'll use it.
The robot has inherently no idea of where it's going, so you have to teach it how to do that.
The task for Professor Charles Kemp's team is to program a healthcare robot to feed a patient a spoonful of yogurt.
I think we're going to have a personal robotics revolution, and one of the great ways in which personal robots will be able to benefit people is to provide this sort of assistance.
Participants get tips on applying to grad school and paying for it. They also learn something lasting. Confidence.
So one of the biggest aha moments I've had interacting with students is when they said, I didn't think I could do it, but now I did.
More than 70% of SURE program participants have gone on to grad school. Now that's getting close to a SURE bet. For Science Nation, I'm Miles O'Brien.